Why no voting system is fair and how artificial intelligence can help. In November 2020, the United States of America will elect a new president. Citizens in the 50 US states will head to the polling stations and vote for the electors of their state. The candidate winning most of the votes by the 538 electors becomes the new US president. Many people argue that this system is flawed. Why? Say, in state X, 60% of the votes go to the Republican and 40% to the Democratic candidate. In that case, all electors of state X cast their votes for the Republican candidate. 40% of the votes are lost and don't count towards the national outcome. The second criticism is that the number of electors per state is not proportional to the number of voters in that state. A citizen in Wyoming has 3 times more influence on the outcome than a voter in densely populated California. In consequence, someone can become president even though a lot more citizens voted for another candidate. You may think the US presidential elections are unfair, but what would be a fair voting system? This is the main question social choice theory tries to answer. How should we aggregate individual points of view to find a compromise that everyone is happy with? It turns out that this is really hard to answer. Let's look at a toy example. Say we have a bowling club with 9 members. The members want to elect a president for their club. Tom, Zoe, and Eva are up for election. Anonymously, each member votes for their preferred candidate. This is the result. The decision seems clear. Eva obtained the most votes and should therefore be the new president. This is the outcome produced by plurality voting. However, Eva did not win the absolute majority, which would be at least 5 votes. The members agreed to let a runoff election between Zoe and Eva decide who should be the new president. This is the result. The 2 voters who previously voted for Tom now vote for Zoe, who has the absolute majority with 5 votes. In plurality voting with runoff, Zoe is the winner. One of the members is still not convinced. To find the best compromise, we have to rank the candidates according to our preferences, he argues. The members agree. Knowing everybody's full preference ranking, they now assign points to each rank. This so-called border voting rule yields this result. Now Tom is the winner. The members are puzzled. With 3 different, well-established voting rules, they obtain 3 different outcomes. Which one should they choose? To argue about the advantages and flaws of different voting rules, social choice theory uses axioms. They describe properties that we want a fair voting rule to have. Anonymity. The identity of voters should not affect the outcome. This axiom is clearly violated by the US elections. If you live in a swing state, your vote has a disproportionately large effect. But if you are a Democrat living in a traditionally Republican state, you might as well not go cast your vote. The Pareto principle. If all voters prefer candidate A over candidate B, B should not win. This sounds pretty reasonable. The next one is a bit tricky. It's strategy proofness. Lying about your true preferences should never be beneficial. Think again about the US presidential election. Say your true favorite party is the Green Party. Are you going to vote for the Green candidate? Probably not. You know that the Green Party is very unlikely to gain most votes in your state and thus your vote would be lost. Non-imposition. Each candidate up for election should be able to win. Technically, the US election system fulfills that criterion. In theory, candidates from all parties can win the election. In practice, though, there are only 2 parties that ever win and share almost all political power. There is no voting rule that fulfills all axioms that we would like to have. In other words, no voting rule is completely fair. In fact, some of the established axioms in social choice theory are incompatible. For example, there is no good voting rule that allows more than 2 alternatives to win and is strategy proof at the same time. Only 1 kind of voting system fulfills both criteria: dictatorship. A system in which a single person determines the outcome for the election, and this is certainly not a fair voting system. The bottom line is this: we can't have it all. Every voting rule has its shortcomings. What we would really need to do is select a voting rule based on the axioms that we deem important in a certain context. You might think this all sounds quite abstract. In the end, voting axioms are logical rules and humans are not particularly good at logical reasoning. This is why clever people came up with computational social choice. Reasoning about voting rules and voting axioms is hard, so we built algorithms to do it for us. These algorithms are most often tools from artificial intelligence, or AI. Now, when I say AI, you're probably thinking about neural networks. With the recent hype about deep learning, AI has become sort of a synonym for machine learning and neural networks in particular. But there is a whole other area of AI which is nowadays often forgotten, the area of symbolic methods. Machine learning is at its best at tasks that are easy for humans but puzzlingly hard for computers, like image recognition or language understanding. But the problems of social choice theory are also hard for humans. They are basically logical riddles. And this is exactly what symbolic AI methods are good at. Rather than detecting patterns in a huge database like machine learning, they find solutions for problems based on logic. Such methods can, for instance, prove that certain combinations of voting axioms are incompatible, or which voting rules obey or violate which voting axioms. Will these approaches improve national elections around the world? Probably not. There are already plenty of ideas on how to vote in a fairer way. However, there is too much at stake for these long-established voting rules to be easily changed. The greater potential for change lies in the choices made by small groups of people in companies, universities, or governments. But also here it holds that complete fairness can never be achieved. In the next video, I will talk you through a concrete example of how AI could help us finding better ways to make decisions. Thanks for watching and see you soon!